Hi guys, welcome to For Those Who Code. In this video, we'll be learning about creating REST API endpoints with Node and Postgres. And we'll be using Express as our framework for our Node application. So let's get started. Okay guys, I assume you have a basic understanding of JavaScript, Node and Postgres, because we'll be not covering every detail involved. But I assure you, you'll be able to create some endpoints after learning from this video. We will be building a food application endpoints. I have broken down this video into four major parts. First, we'll be diving into creating a local database by creating a user and inserting some data in the table first. Second, we'll be connecting our local database with our Node server and spin up a local server ready. Third, we will build the endpoint of creating, reading, updating, and deleting data from our local database. Finally, we'll be testing out our endpoint with Insomnia, which is a REST client I'll be using, and we'll make sure it's working correctly. All of the code of the video is provided with a GitHub link. So let's build it.
And then we will start with yarn init, and will not answer these questions now. And first of all, we'll add yarn add express. And in the meantime, we'll also create app.js file and constant express is equal to require express. And then, we can also write something like app.get and simply slash and add a callback function to it, which takes two objects, which is request and then response. And for now, we are just aiming to run the express server and we'll app response dot send. We are running. All right, const port defined at first. For now 8080, and then we can write app dot listen to this port with a callback function, which response, or we can write console.log and then add some template literals, app listening in port. All right, I think this is okay for now. Yeah, as you can see that our app is listening as 8080, so we have successfully run our Express application, and which is currently serving in the port 8080.
Now I'll just stop the server and I'll start adding our dependencies, like .env, bz, helmet, morgan, node postgres and node bon. .env will help us to access our environment variables and keep it into a single file. Bz will access the pool of queries with bg, and helmet, which adds a security layer for our express application, and node bon, which listens to our all changes when saved. So I'll just go and add these dependencies for now. For first, I will just start with adding a folder for our
configuration. We'll add a file named config.js, and the next file we'll add is server.js, where we'll move this part start server over this file here, and then we need .env that helps us to add our environment variables into a single file, and then we will I think these are ready. Now let's first write some environment variables that we need, and for that I will start with db user and name it like I have, which is the superhead, and database password, which I've already defined before, which is root, and database host, which is currently localhost, since we are still in a development environment, and a port we are running would be 8080, and also we can also add database port, which is default port for PC admin or Postgres, 5432, and lastly the database name. Which is footy, named here footy. So I think these are okay for now. So let's close it. So inside our configuration, we will require .env, the package that we installed, .env. And we will also require this particular file over here, and we will shift this start server over here as well, and const app is equal to require. Let's give our path. We'll also change this to process.env.port, which we are accessing from the environment variable that we created, this one right here. And then we will, I think this is fine for now. We'll move toward server, where first, before writing something in the server.js, this is actually for server.js, and for configuration we will require .env, .config, and then before writing our connection string that we need to add for the for connecting the Postgres, I would like to go and check out express.js, and inside there guide database integration and Postgres. And as you can see here, for the Postgres, we need Postgres username, password, host port, and database name. So we will write this down, but we will write it in according to the environment variable that we defined. over here. So const connection string is equal to keep an add rate just like this one, and we need a host. So host, which we will again access it from the environment variable, and dot db underscore host, which is localhost right now. And then we'll also add our port, we'll also add database name. For reference, let's copy this one and place it here for now, and then comment this one out, and PostgreSQL and username dot dot password, and then let's format this one. I think this is okay for now. Create a constant so that we can know whether the current mode is production or not. Which, of course, we'll access it from node end, which a node core provides us, and production. And now let's const require pool. So let's export it. And export, we will export pool. So before writing anything now, let's take a reference from, and let's go to API pool. And then here we can see that in example we have const pool require busy, which we just recently did. And inside the constant we will have our host, user, and the others are not quite important for now. So like this one, we will connect to our pool, and for that we will create a constant which name it pool, and the new pool, and then inside here we will add our so first we will add connection string, which is if fits in production. We will have process.env dot database URL, and then else we'll have connection string working, and then now add an SSL, which is production. So now everything looks fine and formatted. So we have a required pool and an exported pool, and we also added a connection string, and everything looks fine for me now. So let's move on to our main app.js file, where we will be requiring some packages that we installed, like Morgan. But for now, I think we are not going inside Morgan, but we shall require it. And we shall only if process.env.node environment is strictly is equal to development, we shall use it. Use Morgan, and you can write sort tiny, or we'll add div for now and add a colon. So okay, if the node environment is in development, we will use Morgan, which is the option that Morgan gives is tiny or dev or any other thing, but we will have it dev for now. Okay, so let's add other packages that we installed, like Helmet, which helps in adding a security layer. It's at our node application as well. So Helmet, and then let's use it. Helmet. Now let's add a constant app and Ghost Express, where we will use this particular app to access over here. Oh, already have it, but anyway. And then we shall also use express.json so that it helps in parsing our JSON files. Before we used to require body parser, but right now body parser is inbuilt and integrated inside Express framework. And then now we shall also require pool, which we exported from the config. But we'll use pool later. For now, I think we are okay for now. And module.export, we're exporting the app, app.get. Okay, let's save it and let's see if everything is working fine. So we will start the server. Now it's not app.js, but instead it's server.js. So we have an error, can find modal app. So it can find this. Now let's bring on Insomnia and let's send our request, and we are running. So now it looks like our code is working fine. So let's move ahead and use send some queries to our database, and in the response we will get some data. Now let's create an endpoint get food so that we can get all the list of food that we have in our database. So for that, I'll create a constant and name it get food, and which takes two objects. One is request and one is response, and use a fat arrow. And inside here we will use our pool to send query to our Postgres database. So pool.query, and we'll write down a simple query for getting the list from our database named food. The food is our table name actually, not the database name. So select everything, that is select asterisk from food, and the callback function it takes is error and results. So use a fat arrow, and inside here we can check if there is error, then we can throw an error. But if there is no error, then we can have response that send our status code 200 and parse and send down some JSON with status as success, and then we can also send the request time but the request time is not mandatory and not necessary, where we can access it from request.requestTime. And then we can also write down the data as well, which is results dot rows, which is here results dot rows. We are just accessing the object from our callback function right here. So I think there is some error and status JSON. Sorry, I missed out a bracket. Okay, right down here, format it, and I have pre-read installed, but sometimes it doesn't work. But anyway, response.send. So what we're gonna change is we gotta delete this one, and then app dot route, and introduce our first route, and it's a get, and pass down this constant here and put a semicolon here. So everything looks fine for me. Rest. Our endpoint is fine. So let's write get all food. So right now we can add food over here as well, and let's test it out in our REST client using Insomnia. So
and get send request. Cannot get. Cannot get. And I think we missed out food here. Yeah, we have successfully accessed our Postgres data and returned some data which we inserted before using a command line interface. Now let's move ahead and create other endpoints like get food by ID. Inside here we'll first know which ID that the client is asking for. We can write constant get food by ID, which takes request and response object, and then we use a fat arrow. Inside here we first know the ID that the client is asking for, so const request ID, which is actually we need to parse as a string, and then respond.parent.id. We have response object, and inside that we have parents, and we can access the ID inside the response parents.id, and then we will have pool.query and write our query here. Select asterisk from food, and then where ID is equal to 1, and then we can request ID. And it's small, okay. Pass it down over here, and then add a callback function which takes error and results, and inside here we can check the same which we wrote over here. You can copy it down and paste it over here, format a little bit. If error, throw error. If response, else response.status is 200, then we send down results.rows. Yeah, everything looks fine. Now let's also add our food by ID down here. We have to create app.route and then have food, and then it would be dynamic ID, which is asked by the client, which is response.parents.id, and then we can, it's a get request of course, and pass down here. So I think it looks fine. So let's test it out inside here. We can't read property ID of undefined, and then yeah, it's actually working now, and we can get our food ID 1 as a response and 2. And we get 2, and if we get if we send 1, then we get 1. Okay, this is working fine. So now let's move ahead and create endpoints for updating, or let's create create food. So create food. So for that we'll create a constant, name it new food. and we sticks to request and response object, and then we can have we can like add dish and country, which is inside our request object. So body, and we'll add this query inside here, but I tweak it a little bit. It's not select, instead it's insert into food, dish and country, and then here we can add dish country, and I think I missed out edge dish and country, and for inside the callback we have error and results, and then our response that status is 200 is okay, but we would delete this one and send a new food added. So, and we have this one with here, and it's a post, so we'll add post right here. We'll format this one, and I think this works well. So let's first copy this one and test it out. We are having a post request where we can write post new food and then results. We don't need results, we are not using results now, but anyway I think this works. Let's check it. Server returning nothing to headers, no data. Actually, yeah, I found out the problem. So actually it was a really foolish mistake. Actually I was having a put request, but instead I needed post. So we can write post send new food added. So okay, our create food is also working fine. Now let's move ahead and add update food. So for that we will also create a constant, name it update food, and it takes two object, a request and response, and inside here we will have a constant which would be request ID, the same constant that we created, and just to know which ID is the request coming for, and then another constant we need for this one right here, which takes dish
and country from requester body, and then we will add our query inside pool.query, and our query is update food set dish is equal to 1, and then comma country is equal to 2. So first one here, dish to dish and country to country, and then we should also place an ID as well. So where ID is equal to 3. Now let's add an array where we have country, dish, and request ID, and then it takes a callback function of error and results, and then we can check if it's if there is any error, then we can throw error, and if there is not error, we can send response 200, and of course send status to 200 and then send food modified with ID, this particular ID, then right down here. Okay, so now this looks fine. Before I was hitting a put request, but we haven't created any put request. So I think let's go ahead and also add delete food, and we'll check it after we make our function delete food, and which takes request object and response object, and we can identify the ID that we want to delete first, and then we query down our delete query from food where ID would be 1, and then here we can have request ID that comes from requested parameter ID, and then we have a callback function which take error and results, and then if there is any error, then we should throw error, and if there is no error, then of course we can copy this one and place it over here, format a little bit, and then food deleted with ID, this particular ID that our client requested for. Okay, this looks good. Now let's
delete and then place it over here, and then get post, get put, and delete. Everything looks perfect. So now, yeah, I'll close this for now. I think we have completed our basic API endpoint. So let's test it out. Now, let's test our post endpoint first. We need a post. No, let's test put, because we want to modify our food. So food edited, and then country edited. All right, so now let's send a post request. Cannot post. Oh, still the same mistake. I need to send a put request for the update. So put, and for the ID 2, let's say, and send put modified with ID 2. Perfect. So now this is also working, and get food by ID is also working. Yeah, and then delete food. Let's go ahead and request for delete food, and before that I'll just get all food and then delete 15, 14, and 11. Let's see, 11 food deleted, 11, 15 food deleted, 15, 14 food deleted, 14. Now let's get everything, and we have ID 1 and ID 2 as we have inserted from the CLI. So guys, I hope you got some initial ideas on creating your next REST API endpoints with Node, Express, and Postgres. Thank you so much for watching my videos. If you guys want to learn more about code design and anything more, please like, share, and subscribe with a click down below. I'll be trying to make more better videos like this. Please find the link below to GitHub links and other references I have taken in the video. So see you in the next one.